Alexi, they give me in this session to speak about albumin. I realized, looking at the other speakers, that is focused on the resuscitation treatment. Well, I can anticipate that there are no data, there is not any good physiological background to say that during resuscitation treatment in severe sepsis or in septic shock, where the problem is the capillary leaks, on using albumin in that particular phase. Because speaking about albumin or starches or fluids without understanding or having an idea, well, when they try to fix looks at this is a classical schema. We have intravascular, then we have the interstitium, then we have a lot of intracellular fluid compartment. Now, what we have always to remember is that the difference between the first two compartments is due to the capillary leaks and possibly to the oncotic pressure of albumin. And between the second and the third, which is always ignored, is the fact that we have the pump that throw away sodium and keep in potassium. To maintain the equilibrium, it requires energy. Septic shock is a system, is a disease, it's not a disease, it's a condition in which the energy is absolutely lacking. So, have you an idea of how much fluids goes from intravascular to the interstitium if I take out completely the barrier? Liters, milliliters, tons. Well, consider the oncotic pressure, exerted an oncotic pressure normal albumin of about 2 millimeters of mercury, 2 milliosmol. 2 milliosmol, that means the first compartment, the red, I have 302. In the blue compartment, I have 300 as into the cells. If I want to equilibrate the first two compartments, 5 and 15, and I take away all the capillary problems, the amount of fluids which has to move is around 150 milliliters, which is almost nothing. This is the so-called oncotic power of albumin. In septic shock, I don't have any real capillary. I have some, probably, in some part of the body. But basically, it's no problem. Albumin, this is a complex molecule. I told you about the oncotic power. The weight is about 65,000, and it has a lot of properties which are very good during the septic shock or during the septic stage, because it has some antioxidant, it helps endothelial stabilization, it has some anti-aggregant, is important in acid-base equilibrium, is a modulator of nitric oxide. So there is a lot of properties which are helpful in this condition. But during the resuscitation phase, are not so important. The oncotic, because the oncotic values is completely gone until the full-blown problem has been solved. When we did this study, albumin replacement, the title is Albumin Replacement in Patients with Severe Sepsis and Septic Shock, because we have in one resuscitation phase in which we were giving 60 grams of albumin plus colloid versus the colloid alone, which, more important, was followed by a replacement of albumin every day along 28 days. So the albumin was used not as a system to maintain the osmolarity due to the protein, that means the oncoticity, but was used, at least in our mind, the most important thing were probably the extra oncotic effects of albumin. And this study took two to three years, but we had quite a good enrollment, and notably we lost very, very few patients in follow-up, 7 over 800, 7 over 900. So, and the results, these are the results of the acute phase. Well, you can see the mean arterial pressure. If you look at the mean arterial pressure during the first 6 hours up to the first day, you saw that we have 3-4 millimeters of mercury of difference, which are significant. That means you can attribute or to more volume or to the NO action and so on. But, my dear friend, are 3 millimeters of mercury? To me, it's very difficult to attribute some specific and important value to this difference. And I personally squeeze all the data during the first 6 hours, making a posteriori all the possible subgroup analysis and interpretation that whatever reviewer would kill, but I think are important to try to understand what we are doing, and we couldn't find, I couldn't find, any real difference in between crystalloids and albumin. And this is the central venous pressure, which goes from 10 to 12. Once again, there is a very small difference. You know the problem of this old study, that we look the average. Why sometimes the message is into the standard deviation. In the patient, we stay very up or stay very down. When you say the mortality change of 5%, 5% is just 5 patients over 90, over 100. That means 95%, whatever you do, is exactly the same. But in these small categories of 5%, usually the more fragile, we may induce some problem. The entity of our effort, of our alteration, however, in this particular case, even looking at the quite wide standard deviation, were not such as to lead to any difference in outcome. What is interesting, and is also written in whatever literature book, when the albumin, we consider the day one, day two, day three, when in some patient the problem is overcome and we restore the normal capillary permeability, of course the oncotic pressure play is role, because each milliosmole due to the each milliosmole has an equivalent in hydrostatic pressure between 7, 5, 10 millimeters of mercury. So we facilitate reaching the normal fluid balance. And we know that there are studies saying, okay, I give albumin in day three with some diuretics, I don't change the destiny, I just accelerate the natural process of restoring the normal hydration. And also about the population, about the total population, there is no difference between we couldn't find a difference in the whole population, including sepsis and severe sepsis. However, in these patients, in this group, and in the title of this study, we put sepsis, severe sepsis and septic shock, because in our mind were two separate degrees of severity. In 1,350 patients with septic shock, 46% died versus 34% with severe sepsis. So now with the sepsis 3, we have to look how we change this number. I think we lose some percent of severe septic shock, maybe instead of 1,300, we will have 1,000 or 900 patients. So we will select more severe patient, but I don't think that will dramatically change the cards in table. Anyway, just with definition of sepsis shock, it happens to have some differences in mortality. And this is due to looking at all course of the patient, even not to the initial resuscitation phase, on which we were not able to find any real difference between the two populations. And 6.3% happens to be significant. This was considered as a posteriori, because we did not declare, because we forget really to write in the paper that sepsis and severe sepsis and severe septic shock were two distinct phases of severity, and we stratified the patient according to the time of intervention instead of the severity. That for us was a natural acquisition, was already defined. Anyway, any way you look, it appears that if we look only at the patient with a severe septic shock, and in this patient, I repeat, lactate has not been considered, which is not so terrible, I think. But is clearly it happens that the amount of fluid given to the patient with severe sepsis was with severe septic shock was higher than the patient than the amount of fluid given to patient with severe sepsis. And it appears that whenever you look, without, I think, with no exception in the other sense, it appears that the more severe are the patient, better is the possible benefit of albumin. But all these are, of course, a posteriori, post hoc analysis, and are helpful to understand. Are not what we people now call the evidence, but is anyway the best evidence we have, I think. And it appears this, my friend Cairone, this analysis, this is still unpublished, and we tell you that in the patient with a real severe sepsis, in which the albuminemia was extremely low, the lowest quartile of albumin, you cannot find difference between treatment with albumin or no treatment, which becomes effective when the albumin level was a little bit higher. This has to say, when the patient are too low, the amount we gave were not enough to change the destiny. But in the other categories of patients with septic shock, there is some dependency on the starting level for albumin. So, to conclude, I think that why the positive signal is limited to the most severe patient and quite late. I think I always consider the albumin as a little soldier that circulates in extracellular space with a lot of properties, including the oncotic, which is not the most important. And the albumin replacement play a role when the soldier disappear, are too little, are too few, or they are functionally impaired. The oxidation status of albumin appear to be very important, although I don't have time to go through, but part up to 30-40% of the albumin that we have in a patient is unable, as an example, to modulate NO and to act as oxygen X radical scavenger. So there is still a lot to understand and to proceed. I can tell you that very likely in Germany we start the next year in a sort of second round of this study, in which on about 2,000 patients we will look only patients with severe septic shock. We try to see if the signal we had in this study will be confirmed or not, just to find a definite place for albumin in our armamentarium of treatment. I thank you for the attention.